Hydralazine is an antihypertensive agent used for the management of essential hypertension or severe hypertension associated with conditions requiring immediate action, heart failure, and pre-eclampsia or eclampsia. In this video, let's find found. What is hydralazine? What is hydralazine used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking hydralazine? How does hydralazine work? How to use hydralazine? What is hydralazine? Hydralazine, sold under the brand name Apresoline among others, is a medication used to treat high blood pressure and heart failure. This includes high blood pressure in pregnancy and very high blood pressure resulting in symptoms. Hydralazine was discovered while scientists at CIBA were looking for a treatment for malaria. It was patented in 1949. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. In 2020, it was the 103rd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 6 million prescriptions. What is hydralazine used for? Hydralazine is indicated alone or adjunct to standard therapy to treat essential hypertension. A combination product with isosorbide dinitrate is indicated as an adjunct therapy in the treatment of heart failure. Contraindication. Hypersensitivity to hydralazine, coronary artery disease, mitral valvular rheumatic heart disease are contraindications for its use. Side effects. Common, 1-10% frequency, side effects include flushing, hypotension, anginal symptoms, aching or swelling joints, muscle aches, positive tests for atrial natriuretic peptide, stomach upset, diarrhea, nausea and vomiting, and swelling, sodium and water retention. Very common, greater than 10% frequency, side effects include headache, tachycardia, and palpitations. Prolonged treatment may cause a syndrome similar to lupus, which can become fatal if the symptoms are not noticed and drug treatment stopped. Hydralazine is within the top three drugs that is known to induce lupus, and this adverse drug event is dose-dependent yet significant. Pharmacodynamic. Hydralazine interferes with calcium transport to relax arteriolar smooth muscle and lower blood pressure. Hydralazine has a short duration of action of 2-6 hours. This drug has a wide therapeutic window, as patients can tolerate doses of up to 300 mg. Patients should be cautioned regarding the risk of developing systemic lupus erythematosus syndrome. Mechanism of action. Hydralazine may interfere with calcium transport in vascular smooth muscle by an unknown mechanism to relax arteriolar smooth muscle and lower blood pressure. The interference with calcium transport may be by preventing influx of calcium into cells, preventing calcium release from cellular compartments, directly acting on actin and myosin, or a combination of these actions. This decrease in vascular resistance leads to increased heart rate, stroke volume, and cardiac output. Hydralazine also competes with protocollagen prolyl hydroxylase, CPH, for free iron. The petition inhibits CPH-mediated hydroxylation of HIF-1-alpha, preventing the degradation of HIF-1-alpha. Induction of HIF-1-alpha and VEGF promotes proliferation of endothelial cells and angiogenesis. Half-life. Hydralazine has a half-life of 2.2-7.8 hours in rapid acetylators and 2.0-5.8 hours in slow acetylators. The half-life in heart failure patients is 57 to 241 minutes with an average of 105 minutes and in intensive patients is 200 minutes for rapid acetylators and 297 minutes for slow acetylators. Hydralazine is subject to polymorphic acetylation. Slow acetylators generally have higher plasma levels of hydralazine and require lower doses to maintain control of pressure. However, others, such as acetylation being a minor metabolic pathway for hydralazine, will contribute to differences in elimination rates. Dose. Severe essential hypertension. 10 mg POQ6HR for 2 to 4 days, 25 mg QQ6HR daily for the first week, increase to 50 mg Q6HR from second week on, adjust dose to lowest effective levels. 20 to 4 mg IM/4, repeat as necessary. Hypertension, chronic. Initial, 10 mg POQ6HR for 2 to 4 days, may increase gradually by 10 to 25 mg/dose every 2 to 5 days up to 50 mg POQ6HR, some require 300 mg per day. See also combo with isosorbide dinitrate. Hypertensive crisis. 10 to 40 mg 4/IM, not to exceed 20 mg per dose, repeat PRN. Pregnancy associated. 5 to 10 mg 4/IM initially, then 5 to 10 mg Q20-30 minute PRN, or 0.5 to 10 mg/HR for infusion. Congestive heart failure. Initial dose, 10 to 25 mg POQ6-8HR. Titrate dose 2-4 weeks. Maintenance dose, 225 to 300 mg/day PO divided Q6-8HR. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about hydralazine we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.